Before I start this video, I want to give a big shout out to MrRoffelwaffles. Now, I watched his video about different sides of the zombie community, and I thought that he actually did a really, really good job at explaining different standpoints. So if you guys want to kind of see the concept that I'm going for, but I'm kind of going to be more just biased, but if you want to get the inspiration of this video idea, go check out Milo. His link will be in the description. Now, today's video is going to be kind of a little bit of the opposite of a video I made about a week ago almost, where I talk about Cod Next and the zombies reveal specifically, and I just talk about how dog shit it was for the hardcore players.
Chat, this is kind of nice, actually.
12 seconds later.
Oh, man.
Super hard to put in, but it's something we really cared about putting in. So,
you guys seem to really, really enjoy that video. So I thought, what would happen if I took that video idea of me going through Cod Next and I actually flipped it, turned it on its head, and instead of talking about the negatives that I see and being more subjective about it, I talk about the positives, because at the end of the day, I'm looking at this through the lens of a round-based player. That's what I'm doing, that's how I see it. But I think it would be awesome if I see it in a little bit more of a positive light. It's really, really hard for me because the way they market this game, I think, is the worst part about it. They market it as a zombies experience, talking about we have stuff for hardcore players. And that feels like a slap to the face because it feels like they don't know what the hardcore players are. So I'm just gonna try to be less upset about the way they're marketing the game and just look at the game for the face value of what the game mode is. We have gameplay from different YouTubers. We have a lot of revealing evidence. We have trailers. We have discussions. Now it is time to sit down and talk about, well, if this wasn't going to be marketed to zombie players, how would I feel about the mode? This is what I think is the first time in history where they're making a zombie mode not catered to zombies. Yeah, yes, you can try to argue that this mode is catered to Outbreak, but I think it's really more catered to DMZ. Similar map scale, similar idea fighting AI, you have in-game voice chat, and you have no private play. It's a public-only thing, with it being a whole sandbox of other people in your game, even though it's not PvP. So a lot of people try to see this game and say, well, it's kind of like Outbreak, but expanded. But I would disagree. I would say it's more DMZ, but with zombie elements inside of it. So that's what I think is really the main thing I can think of here. So I think even Outbreak players are going to enjoy the game more than maybe your typical round-based hardcore old school zombies. I love Black Ops zombies like me, but I feel like even the Outbreak players are going to go into this and it's going to be a completely new feeling. And I don't know if that they're going to, I think the transition will be easier, but I don't think it'll be easy like a one-to-one. While DMZ, it's way, way more, I think, of an easier transition. You're used to that big sandbox, that huge map, the different levels of it. You're used to seeing other people in the game. This is a completely foreign feeling that zombies has never had before, having a bunch of other players play at the same time, or this is something that DMZ has had. It's a completely online game mode, which means, you know, you can't play private matches. Solo is basically saying you shouldn't play that way, and I feel like the game mode overall is really, really struggling to connect with those zombie players. But if I look at the game mode, just not from a zombie's lens, I actually think it looks all right. It looks very, very casual. And the gameplay that we saw, even when they're in the third level, I'm not gonna lie, doesn't look very hard. There's a lot of interesting features that they actually think do a pretty good job at explaining what they could be. Systems like starting with different kinds of guns, systems like pack-a-punch and all that, those are really, really cool and all, but how will they enhance the mode and keep that replayability throughout the entire game? This mode was clearly built for those DMZ players and maybe even those Outbreak players. It is very, very possible that they say, okay, you know what? Those DMZ Outbreak players, you know, this year we're going to cater to you. We're going to give you this mode. But next year when it's our title, we're going to go back to our roots and do round-based zombies. Now, yes, it's possible that next year they also do a 50-50 mode where it's half round-based, half Outbreak. We don't really know if they're going to do something like that. But this year, they're saying, you know what? We're going to do this style of zombies. And if it does well, then maybe they'll enhance it for the next game. And I'm going to be honest. I think the game's going to do very, very well. Especially among the casual audience. Anytime you want to upgrade a gun, maybe this is the perfect game mode to go into to upgrade your weapons. That's something that you saw in Outbreak a lot that people did. Just go in and upgrade their weapons. And people that played DMZ like that more casual feeling without that stress of Warzone, I feel like we'll have fun jumping into this as well. It's higher stakes than a normal multiplayer, because you don't respawn all the time. But I don't know how high stakes it is compared to Warzone, because Warzone, obviously, you're playing PvP and it's a big, big sweat fest. This isn't going to be a sweat fest. It's going to be a very casual game. Still, though, if I'm looking at this not as a zombie mode and I'm just thinking this is a game to play, I'm going to be honest, I'm not really blown away. This game mode doesn't really show me anything completely insane that I'm like, oh my god, I have to play this. There's obviously cool things, and I think the coolest thing that they've revealed so far is the world bosses. I think that's such an awesome idea, and I wish that more zombie maps had more complex bosses, like Attack the Rare Thing, or Destiny-styled bosses. I think that'd be so great for zombies. But how difficult will these world bosses actually be? And when they say world bosses, do they mean one big boss and then mimics? How big is this world boss going to be? Does Treyarch and Activision and everybody in Call of Duty have the capabilities to actually make a really, really good world boss? That's something we're going to have to figure out. So even looking at this mode, not from a zombie player perspective, but as, you know, just a Call of Duty fan, I'm still very skeptical of how it works. I feel like it's going to be successful in the casual audience, but I also feel like there's not going to be a dedicated fan base towards it. How many people are really going to be playing this daily like you see people play Call of Duty Zombies? That's really my main issue, is their advertising, the way they advertise this mode. And the second thing that I think is a huge issue is just the replayability. The map feels generic, non-zombified, which even if I'm not a zombie fan, I would like to see at least some difference between this one and the Warzone one. Now, technically, we haven't seen anything, and it is a little bit darker, but I don't think brightness has enough to do with that. I'd like to see these challenges that they have expanded upon in new updates, make them more interesting, and hopefully it's not like Vanguard where you do the same three challenges and then you're done. What if every single time you go through, the challenges are in different locations, they do different things, there's different challenges altogether, so it gives a level of replayability and makes it so that no two games are the same. How impactful are these side Easter eggs going to be? Is the world just going to be a bland Warzone map? Are you really, really going to intertwine and put a ton of content through every area so that half the map isn't wasted space? One of my biggest concerns is if you spawn on the very right side of the map, then why would there be any reason to go on the left side at all? Is there no reason at all? Because if I feel like if I go around, I'm just wasting time because I got that 1 hour time limit. These are all questions that I have right now, but I feel like could really be easily answered. And I feel like this new game has a really good opportunity to capture a casual audience so that the next game, the big zombies game, round-based track game next year in 2024, really, really elevates and does an amazing job. All right, so now this section of the video is just going to be me watching gameplay of this new mode, because I'm not going to watch the trailers. Trailers are CGI and they could really hype it up. So I feel like this gameplay is really going to be a good tell. Go subscribe to CodenamePizza. He actually uploads the gameplay with no commentary, which I do appreciate, even though I love hearing the thoughts of other creators. I'm just going to go into this mode thinking about it not in a zombies way, because I feel like they've been marketing it really bad. But here we go. I mean, right away, you can tell the vehicles are going to be a lot of fun to go, and traversing the map itself is going to be a lot of fun in the beginning. What it looks like is that the zombies aren't really in the world. They're more section based. You don't see just a couple of straggler zombies over here or even behind them. You can tell they're not worried about anything behind them at a wall. It sounds like that the zombies are more struck like section based, and they're not actually poured throughout the world. I mean, obviously they're throughout the world, but they're more section based. Like, do they respawn? Like, is there gonna be zombies in the distance? I don't know, because seeing zombies in distance can help with a little bit with the ambiance, and it's not only seeing zombies in your area maybe can take you out a little bit on the sort of lonely feeling of your squad. Sidemen suggest they're coming from that stronghold. Never liked the PNGs, didn't like it in Cold War, didn't like it in Vanguard. I think this one looks better and all, but I just wish there was an animation. You know what to do. Whoa. This looks like a challenge of some sort. Wow, this reminds me of the alien defense game that I played on the original Xbox. That's what this reminds me of, on the 360. We'll give it one thing. I think the double points logo is really, really cool. I like the counter on it. So you can see right here the fact that you're able to join up with other squads. I think that's really great. It looks like they're in zone 2. It says medium threat. Also, you got score streaks. This looks like a Gersh device, actually, or that what they called it in Cold War. This looks like C4. This looks like, obviously, his gun ammo here. We got, I think it's Pack-a-Punch level 2, alternate ammo type, Blast Furnace. And then this looks like Energy Mine. And so it looks like those are going to be returning. Man, it'd be cool to see new ones. I would see Energy Mine. But I'd like to see, you know, Toxic Growth, Frenzy Guard. Let me see these other cool ones, not just the basic ones. And we got Scorch Streak. The HUD looks fine. The HUD looks good. Oh, so you can. So once you go into a new zone, you can actually go back into the old zone. Interesting. See how you walk in, there's no zombies. Like, oh, I guess there is zombies there. But look, as you fly over, you don't see zombies just around in the area. They're very section-based, which I don't think is a good thing. I wish that there was, even if it was like 5 total zombies just walking around, it would feel more real. I mean, obviously, not going for realism, but Modern Warfare Universe tends to feel more realistic than Treyarch, so I feel like they are going for that just a little bit. Okay, it looks like they're doing a little bit of a challenge here. We got the precision airstrike here. And it looks like they're blowing the boy up. That's a really sick burst device, I can't lie. And hold up, let me look at that real quick. Who killed him? Shock Troop. Okay, so there's like kind of the AI you got there. That's kind of cool. That's really sick. It's so funny seeing that the Gerst device affects humans but not you. It's really funny, actually. Okay, so this looks like one of those AI outposts of people. Looks like you got one here as well on the bridge. Now, do these move or are they in the same spot every time? Like, am I going to go through the game and that's just a person area? Or will the bases move throughout the map? That's really something that I wonder as well. That's like if they moved around the map, that would give a level of replayability. They don't look hard. They look easy to kill. I mean, he does have a level 2 pack-a-punch gun, but it's not like they look difficult. You can see that her thing changed. I don't know what the red means. Maybe it's because they're in combat. And this gun here is... What is that? Purple. Is that a field upgrade? Is that part of the Wonder Weapon? I don't know. Grunt. So it looks like there will be level-based enemies and AI too. Maybe there's a grunt, there's a sergeant, there's a commander, maybe there's a juggernaut you can fight. We don't know. Give me Left 4 Dead vibes, honestly. So he's got a shield. That's cool that the different types of shoulder. Nice. Seemed really easy to kill, like I said. They're all just standing there? And this is in their gameplay? They're just standing there? Okay, that didn't look very good. That looked like the AI was wonky, is what it looked like. But it'll probably be fixed by the time. This is what I'm talking about. Look, you got zombies over here, you got a zombie over here, you got a zombie down here, a zombie down here. You see how they're scattered? That's what I'm talking about. That's what I want. Such simple detail. Maybe some over here, some over here. Obviously, they can't be everywhere. But that feeling, maybe it is everywhere, and this is just zone 1, that's why it feels lower, but be awesome if you felt sort of, if you felt deserted in a sense. You felt always at risk. Even if it's very minor. Looks like soldiers can move around. That's really cool that soldiers can move around. I like that a lot. Why is the insta-kill only 27 seconds? Hasn't it always been 30? Monkey bomb. So let's see this feature. So you got the monkey bomb. Zombies run towards it. Looks like that's one of the activities you gotta do. Interesting. Okay. And look at that. You can see Pack-a-Punch right there on his mini-map. This is one of the only modes that it makes sense to have a mini-map. It doesn't make sense to have it in normal zombies, but in this, it does. Here's another sort of outpost type of thing. Oh, wow. They're throwing hella monkeys over there. What the hell? Holy shit. This player sucks dick. No, I'm kidding. What Activision dad is playing this? Kevin Drew's this you? Looks like there's a counter UAV or something for it. EMP or whatever? I don't know, I think this is a Ring of Fire, is it? Is that a new one? Ether Shroud, go. Maybe I'm missing that. Not Frostblast, not Energy Mine. Okay, so there you go. Looks like we are in level 2 now, so we got some more bosses over here. This is a really, really cool angle, actually. See how the person's on top? That's pretty cool. We got a Mangler in there, some zombies, but they're all, like I said, they're all in one section. Why aren't they over here? Why aren't they over here? Hellhound. Oh, that was sick. Oh, shit. Did he actually flop? Oh, is he actually dolphin diving? Oh, he's dolphin diving. It's actually PhD flopper. Oh, that's so sick. Oh, and it looked like it did some damage. That was really, really good. That was sick. Looks like she's got... Is that supposed to be Ring of Fire, but like new version of Ring of Fire? Where you can move around with it? I don't know what that's supposed to be. I think it's Ring of Fire. That's Frost Blast for sure. Okay, we're in level 1. We have some Hellhounds. But it looks like we're getting some level 2 zombies in here, though. What is that? Armor. Oh my lord, I didn't even realize that. So it's armor plates. And actually, well, now that I think about it, look, they're not dropping salvage at all. The salvage system is obsolete. Instead, they're dropping ammo. They're dropping... I'm guessing they're going to drop lethal tacticals. Maybe big zombies drop score streaks. Maybe perks. But look, they have an armor plate system. It's not the Cold War salvage system. That's very interesting. I think that's a good thing. As long as they still got Jug. Which I think they do. There's no way they'd get rid of Jug after what happened last time. Ooh, okay. Looks like we got something here. Is that a portal of some sort? Oh. Oh, it's just a holdout. Man, it's just a holdout. Oh, here's the Wonder Weapon. Okay. Oh, that's sick. Oh, this is that thing earlier that you can, like, leak onto other people. So that's probably a new field upgrade, which is good. I love that. That's a really good Wonder Weapon. Do you wonder how much range it has? Can it shoot far distance? Maybe a long distance Wonder Weapon like a sniper would be awesome. But I'm going to guess that they add more Wonder Weapons. If they don't add more Wonder Weapons in this... Obviously, like I said, nothing that'll hinder that replayability. So we got a zip line to a little island here. We got a toxic area. Whoa. These zombies look cool. I'm guessing this is part of like the storm. Oh, and he's got a gas mask. Holy shit, they look sick. Okay, this is really cool. I like the colorway, I like the purple on it. Damn, look at that storm. That's awesome. Looks like... So if you kill those storms, man, do you get some certain abilities with it? Do you get extra things? I'm guessing you do. Maybe it's part of world bosses. We don't know. Man, they got a lot of different challenges, it looks like. But they're a lot of very outbreak challenges, you know what I mean? It's like, okay, hold out again. Okay, escort. Okay, defuse the bomb. It's like... Are those really that interesting? It's just kind of the same thing. I guess they're contracts, though. I guess it's not part of this. Is it a part of the main story, or is it just like sort of side contract? I'm not sure. So I did hear that. Oh, that's an awesome camo. Really, really good camo there. I know it was shown earlier, but I gotta give props to the camo. The camo's nice. So these vehicle battles, I think, will be really, really cool. But is this something you can jump in solo? I feel like the obvious answer is no. That's such a big thing. I love solo play. The PNG on the right side of the screen does make sense in this mode than it would in zombies. I don't hate it in this mode because it feels more Warzone-y. I don't actually hate it. Okay, hold up. We got a disciple here. Looks like you can take a lot of hits with armor. They got no perks. So a disciple is going to be a world challenge. It's not just going to be throughout the map. That's interesting. It's going to be a contract. It looks like a bounty. I guess that kind of makes sense. Can you teleport? No? The tactical shooting doesn't make sense for zombies. This guy feels like one of those boss, those people in Destiny, the Disciple does. One thing I'll give Cold War, they have a nice variety of different enemies, and I think that's really, really cool in this kind of mode. Okay, so we're in threat level 3. Oh, and look at the color. Okay. You got a very yellowish... You know what it kind of feels like? It's Breaking Bad when you're in Mexico, actually. It's a very more yellow colorway over it, which I think is nice. I like the idea that it's harder. It's a lot different. Everything's more red, high threat. And they're running more this time. We got a ray gun. It is not pack-a-punch. And that ray gun is ass. And you do splash damage to yourself, it looks like. And you don't pack... It's not pack-a-punch, though. Armored zombies. So armored zombies are returned. A light armored zombie, which means there's heavy. That ray gun is ass cheeks, but it makes sense. It's not a pack-a-punch. That's a rift. Fortnite. Looks like we got Fortnite. Wish there is also a little bit of a storm effect outside of this area, not just sort of the yellowish thing. Oh, whoa. Let's go back there. He kind of looks over around the map. I want to look at that. So, we're in the yellow area, and look at this area. So, remember earlier we were talking about that toxic area, and look at that. That looks really, really cool from up top. I don't think the circle's necessary unless you're on the ground. But I like that purple smoke. I wish that the middle area maybe was a red smoke, because isn't it kind of like, okay, well, this is where he threw the ether, or what's his name? Is it Zakaev? The guy from Modern Warfare. The guy that throws the ether, hits it up, blows it up. I feel like it'd be cool to see that in the level 3 area where it's got this... I like the colorway, but maybe it had this yellow sort of gas around it. Just some fog or something to make it more interesting. Not Origins fog, nothing stupid like that. Just something on the outside so that you can distinct the difference more than just the mini-map. We're back to level 1. In that air bit, I didn't see any world boss, but that's going to be on purpose. And look, yeah, see, it's just another escort. It's just another escort mission. It's like, okay, we're escorting again. Also, this is elemental. Is this elemental? No, this is Deadshot. Mangler's cool. It looks like you can have the Mangler in level 1 area, which is interesting. I don't think you can have that. But he's definitely not going to be very good. He's like a level 5 Mangler. You know, around 5 Mangler, sorry. Okay, like, this animation is cool and all, but, like, what does it actually do? Does it close the portal? Does it kill all the zombies around you? There we go. Yes, this is what we want to see. This reddish-yellowish look is really cool. Really like this, and okay. Still, though, you don't see zombies dispersed. They're more kind of shown in just their one area. Even in this level 3 area, you still have to deliver the cargo. And it's still 2k? That's it? Not worth more because it's in level 3? Interesting. I would think it'd be worth more. Looks like the level 2 area is a little bit darker and more bleak than the level 1 area too. I love those distinctions. I love those distinctions. Oh yeah, 1581 minutes. Don't think we're gonna have that much time, bro. Modern Warfare always has great animations. It's just so weird to see it in a zombie game, you know? Okay, look, they got perks. They got Death Perception, Speed Cola, and Jug on the bottom. Okay. How many perks you can start with this game? Okay. There's the bunny. Teddy bear. And... Okay, there we go. So this guy's a juggernaut. We got the Mega Abomination. And yeah, you can obviously tell it's for... Wow. Oh my lord. I like the triple pack cam with the purple. He's big. But he's not as big as I thought he'd be, actually. So I gave my overall thoughts, I watched some gameplay, and I have a little bit of a reflection now, and a little bit to justify how the way I feel. And overall, my opinion is this. Does it look like a fun mode? Yes. Does it look like something that I'm going to sink all the time, couple times a week into? No. Is it something where... when an update comes out, interests me, I might play it once or twice a month? Sure. But would I rather have them not make this mode and use all those resources to make the next round-based game? Probably. Sadly, I think the mode looks really, really cool. But obviously, I'm a sucker for round-based zombies, ladies and gentlemen, and that's just what I love. So, looking over at the gameplay and everything else, I can appreciate the idea and inspiring to be... this really, really expansive mode. But I just don't... I feel like it's something that I'm not going to play very often after the first 2 weeks. So, yeah, ladies and gentlemen, I hope you guys really did enjoy. If you guys did, make sure to leave a like and subscribe. And, well, check out this sponsor. I'm AI with the braids. I'm AI with the braids. I'm AI with the braids. Dribble rock crossover.
And now, folks, it's time to say goodnight. We sincerely appreciate your patronage and hope we've succeeded in bringing you an enjoyable evening of entertainment. Please drive home carefully and come back again soon. Good night.